Wow, I survived my fourth sing-off. I still can't believe this. Oh? Do I need to erase it as quickly as she did with Pandora's message? No, I want to give her a chance to say her last words at least. Well, I melted. Madison and baby, you deserve to go all the way. See you soon. I feel like Candice got stuck in her own head just like she did in season 5, and that was her downfall again. Also, Lyra, I'm coming for your record. Floplexia is born.
It's sad to see Candice go home. She was one of my girls, and she was so confident about her entry.
After the results, I'm feeling mixed emotions. On the one hand, I'm glad Candice is gone. Not that she's a horrible person, but she was getting on my nerves a lot, and now I can hopefully focus more on myself than on drama. On the other hand, I'm disappointed with how the recent weeks have been going for me. I can feel the crown slip out of my reach, and I need to step my pussy up immediately if I want to have a shot at winning it. The others better watch out, because I'm not holding shit back. Oh, at all.
The winner of Daniel's song race receives a 1-year supply of forum fame and a cash prize of $1.
Another new day in the workroom. Candice is gone, and it is pretty sad because even though I was against Candice being here, she grew on me like a rash. But everyone knew she had it coming.
This is the actual top 6, like, can you believe it?
Ooh, girl!
Racers, I'm not sure if you can hear me. I'm stuck in the 50s, where true music was born. Chanters and chanteuses ruled the world. Can you bring them back to life and get me out of here?
Is that a retro challenge?
Hello, hello, hello. My top 6 queens. This week, you'll have to make the judges and me feel nostalgic, as you will have to send songs published before the year of 1960.
A perfect challenge for Floplexia to show her potential.
I love the challenge idea. Retro challenges in general are amazing, and this one is the most retro there is. Too bad Miss Tara didn't live long enough to be here and send a song she grew up with.
Alright ladies, for this week, we are being joined by the one and only Gallum to judge you all. Don't forget to slay it. Good luck, and don't fuck it up. Bye girls.
So the week's challenge is vintage, and I am actually feeling this challenge a lot, as there are a lot of songs that I can pick from. I can already see with my third eye that Dyslexia is going to ask Koth for help.
Hey sis, how are you feeling about this challenge?
Honestly, it took me a while to find an entry, but in the end I decided to go with Edith Piaf.
Congratulations, you're a champion.
You really think I could win?
Well, I wouldn't be shocked if you did.
That would be hot. What are you sending though?
I'm going for Ema Sumac. Last week I got told how I didn't stand out enough, and that shall not happen this week. Some mambo will spice this week up. I really try to listen to the judges' critiques and adjust. Hopefully it pays off, as I absolutely stand my song.
Hey, that's my line. Anyway, can't wait for the bop. What are your predictions for the rest?
Well, I could see Dyslexia struggle again. She asked me for my opinion, and I told her Elvis was the best choice out of her options, but looking at the other queens, I'm not sure she will do well.
I could see her bottoming.
Then maybe Baby Adams too. She just came back and won, but I don't feel like the song this week stands out.
I mean, I personally like her entry, so I'm not sure about that.
Anything can happen though. I myself could bottom if the risk doesn't pay off, but hopefully that won't happen.
Then there's Auth too. She is probably going to do well in my opinion.
Yeah, Judy is an icon and the song isn't bad either, so I guess she'll do well. But again, nothing is set in stone.
I just hope that your prediction about me is right. I want to have a margin to the rest of the bunch.
Well, obviously I don't want you to win over me. It would keep things more excited if I did. Sorry, sis. But yeah, I think the judges will like you again. This week will be nerve-wracking because the results are even less predictable as usual. As we already established.
Wait. Are we forgetting someone?
No, I don't think so.
Not anyone relevant, at least.
Exactly. Anyway, I'll let you continue preparing.
Thanks, babe. See you later.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to episode 11 of Daniel's Song Race, season 6. Bjork, do you remember the swinging 50s?
Excuse me, I'm not that old.
Sorry about it. My dear Callum is back. Girl, where you been?
I've been drinking almost every night because I couldn't be here. But luckily I could come for the best week of all of them.
This week, our queens will have to present songs that were published before the year 1960. Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines. And may the best song win.
Up his side, in such a change from old routine.
These rocks don't lose their shape. Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
Tiffany's.
Welcome back, ladies. Let's see who took us all the way back to the past and who got stuck in time. Starting with dyslexia.
Well, here we go again.
Oh, sweetie. I can see you're trying very hard. But unfortunately, I wasn't a huge fan of your song. I'm not generally a fan of Elvis either. I'm sorry.
Unfortunately, I'm not really into Elvis music and thus this song leaves me a bit indifferent.
Oh.
Moving on to Auth.
Well, hello there.
Another week, another wig snatched. I absolutely adore this song. Her legacy will definitely live on in the form of a black woman. I mean, oops.
I have decided to fucking stan. Miss Auth, you gave us an iconic bop. No words really, just congratulations.
It was a good song, darling, but I am sure there's more. You could do better.
Thank you, judges.
Next up is Baby Adams.
Yes, hello there.
This song is sweet. I can definitely see why you chose it. However, it wasn't my favorite this week by far.
Nina Simone is a wonderful artist, no doubt for that. But I'm sad to say that the song did not manage to stand out for me this week.
I love Nina Simone and the song is truly beautiful. I'm sad that not all the judges could agree on it.
Oh, thank you anyway.
Moving on to Madison.
Hey. Probably the song that I was the most familiar with. That being said, it's a classic jam and I'm here for it.
Iconic song, iconic woman, iconic impact.
Marilyn is an amazing singer, although I felt this song was just good. Not a banger or anything. But well done.
Thanks, guys.
Next up is Curry Ray Jepsen.
My wig flew to Paris and back. Lavion Rose is one of the most iconic songs of all time and it deserves everyone's love and praise. IZ1 K-pop trash could never.
Sadly, I am not feeling this at all. I'm afraid it was the only song that bored me.
I'm sorry.
While I do think it's a lovely choice you made, I cannot say that I particularly love the song. It's a good song, but it fails to captivate me fully.
Are you insane, girl?
Oh, honey, you did not just do that. I don't care what you other plastic whores say, this is an absolute classic.
Last but not least, it's Gloria Hole.
To your service.
Bitch. What the fuck was that? What the fuck was that sludge? We went back to the 50s and never returned.
Oh my god, thank you.
Gloria, honestly, what a bop. It's a song from the 50s and I could easily see myself jamming to it in 2019.
An absolute banger you sent, Miss Gloria. I absolutely love this song. Thank you for making my ass twerk this week.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Alright, thank you, judges. I think we've heard enough. While you girls untuck backstage, the judges and I will deliberate. Well, just between us gals, what did you think of our queens tonight? Starting with Dyslexia.
Once again, Dyslexia doesn't send a bad song, but a song that is worse than others.
We are at a point in this competition where taking risks could have its consequences.
Off.
Judy Garland is one of the best actresses of all time. Musician, not so much. Although this song is very pleasant.
Off has definitely been on the rise, and it's good on these crucial last challenges.
Baby Adams.
Baby Adams came back stronger as ever, but now she kinda flatlined again. Hopefully this isn't as fatal as it was last time for her.
For me, she just proved again that she deserved to return.
Nina Simone is universally renowned as one of the greatest singers of all time. It's not hard to see why. This song was absolutely fantastic and heartfelt, and I am just so glad this was sent.
Madison Marie de Longpre.
Not disappointing at all, I quite liked this song. Just would have loved to see another song of hers.
I think it was a pretty clever choice and in general a respectable attempt.
Curry Ray Jepsen.
I was left a bit disappointed from one of the frontrunners.
I think that Curry has been on the same, good of course, note for a while. Maybe she should step out of her comfort zone a bit.
Y'all are being a bit rough on her. At least my big boob twin Callan agrees with me.
Yes, I do.
Gloria Hole.
Words cannot describe how good this is.
Nothing bad to say, I'm impressed once again.
Gloria upped her game again, I'm glad for her.
Alright, silence. I've made some decisions. Bring back my girls. Welcome back, ladies. Before we begin, I would like to know from all of you, who do you think should be going home tonight? And why? Starting with Dyslexia.
Well, I must say Madison. Because from everyone left here, I feel like her and I don't have that much of a connection.
Off.
At this point in the competition, the smallest detail must be taken into consideration. Even though I do not agree with all of her bottom placements and believe she should have won two challenges, there's still an odd one out in my sister, Dyslexia. I love you, you know that, but this is not your time just yet, and I hope you can improve yourself if you are being reinvited for a later season of All Stars.
I thought Auth and I were the closest friends here. But it seems more and more like we're getting further from each other.
Baby Adams.
I personally think Madison should go home. Sashay says.
Madison.
First of all, I'm picking your ass for calling me out, Miss Adams. You should have just stayed eliminated. But then, I think that Gloria should go home. She doesn't hold the star quality as other queens here.
Curry Ray Jepsen.
We've come so far in the contest and obviously I'm very proud of all the girls tonight. But, that being said, it's not really a difficult decision for me to say who should be going home. And for me, that's Madison. She is my biggest competition at this point, so no shade on that, but honestly, her attitude just grinds on me in all the wrong ways and I really can't stand her presence in this workroom. Ever since she called me out on the runway a few weeks ago, the atmosphere in the workroom has become very uncomfortable for me with her still in it, and that's why I'm saying Madison.
Gloria Hole.
Even though I feel bad saying it, Dyslexia's time might be up. While she did not do a terrible job this week, her track record speaks for itself. Especially compared to everyone else's. It's great she made it this far, but I don't see her having a realistic shot at the crown anymore.
All right, thank you all for your honesty, ladies. This is it. I have made some decisions. Madison Marie de Longpre, you are safe. Off. You are safe. Gloria Hole, you got us up dancing on our feet like it's the 1950s. Congratulations, you're the winner of this week's challenge. You've won a broken vinyl record with all the 50s hits, and an expired 50 euros little coupon.
Wig, I'm glad my risk paid off. I really wasn't sure how I would do, but I'm back in the race.
Dyslexia. You took a risk, but you didn't make us rock. I'm sorry, my dear, but you're up for elimination.
Well, now I'm even more of a legend by bottoming 5 times.
Baby Adams. Your choice was praised, but do you have enough support? Curry. The judges want you to step out of your box more and take a risk. Baby Adams. I'm sorry, my dear, but you're up for elimination. Curry, you're safe. Two queens, stand before me. You were asked to prepare a sing-off for the category, Low BPM. This is your last chance to impress me and save yourselves from elimination. The time has come for you to sing it for your life. Good luck, and don't fuck it up.
I'm just gonna move like a
ladies, I have made my decision. Baby Adams. Shantae, you stay. Dyslexia, your charm will be missed. But now, sashay away.
Thank you for this amazing opportunity, and I love you all. For now, Floplexia is leaving. I'm sad to leave, but this was my time. May the best queen win. Orth. Just joking, girls, you all deserve this crown. Danielle, thank you, and make the right choice when the finale comes around.